Assalamualaikum Sobat Juru Kunci Masjid. Setiap video yang kami unggah harus kami komentari sebelumnya. Namun jika Anda tidak berkenan, silakan Anda percepat untuk langsung masuk ke video aslinya yang sudah kami terjemahkan. Video kali ini merupakan kesaksian dan kisah seorang mu'alaf dari India yang masuk Islam. Semula mu'alaf ini beragama Hindu, yang kemudian pada perjalanan selanjutnya dia menjemput hidayah Islam. Beberapa saat yang lalu kami melihat tampilan iklan YouTube yang berisi ajakan untuk masuk ke sebuah situs yang berisikan konten Islami yang telah dipelintir isi dan maknanya sehingga malah menyesatkan umat Islam. Mereka menggiring pembaca dan mengarahkannya untuk meyakini bahwa Nabi Islam adalah Tuhan. Mereka bahkan memanipulasi ayat-ayat Al-Quran guna membenarkan pendapat mereka. Namun bagi mereka yang tidak paham, ternyata ayat-ayat tersebut telah disesatkan terjemahan dan maknanya, bahkan jauh dari terjemahan aslinya. Website-website tersebut adalah isadanalquran.com, isadanislam.org, videoisadanislam.com, isadanislam.org. Kami pernah mencoba menghubungi kontak person dari website tersebut dan ternyata mereka sangat responsif dan sangat welcome. Bahkan mereka bersedia diajak dialog bertemu secara face to face. Dan hebatnya lagi mereka punya personel-personel di beberapa wilayah Indonesia. Kemudian mereka juga menggunakan teknik optimasi yang canggih untuk mendukung agar website-website mereka masuk ke dalam ranking halaman pertama di search engine. Sehingga apabila ada beberapa orang yang membutuhkan literatur masalah keislaman, akan secara otomatis oleh search engine direkomendasikan ke website-website mereka. Jadi ini sangat berbahaya sekali bagi umat Islam, karena bisa meracuni, bahkan bisa merusak iman dan akidah kita. Analisa kami, mereka memiliki sumber daya dana yang sangat besar untuk operasi ini. Jadi tolong informasi ini segera di-share, guna melindungi iman dan akidah kita sebagai umat Islam. Nah, sekarang mari kita ikuti videonya berikut ini.
Take care of the big things and the small things will fall into place. My name is Salman. I am from India and I've been a Muslim for 6 years. Alhamdulillah. My story begins where one of my friend from the school, he gave me something to think about. He talked to me about life, about death, about the hereafter, which I had never heard before. That was the first time I was hearing about something, you know, that comes after this life. And he told me that there is a place where you can enjoy without any limits, where you don't have any restrictions, where it's pure, solid enjoyment. And then, on the other hand, there is another place which has total punishment, devastation, only and only suffering. And I was like, thinking about it, and that got me interested to think about this life and to become serious about this life. And then what I was doing in life. What is the purpose of this life? What is the meaning of life? Then I realized everything in this world has a purpose. Everything has a reason to exist. There is nothing that exists or nothing that happens without any purpose or without any reason. So This led me into thinking that why am I here? What am I doing here? What am I supposed to do here? And what's going to happen once I go away from here? And when anyone thinks this way, he's getting serious about life and he's thinking about religion. So then I got back to him. I asked him a few questions. I said, so tell me more about that, what you were saying before. Then he told me some things about religion. He told me about my own religion, which is Hinduism at that time. He told me that, you know, there is only one God. Okay, what's the best place to learn about religion? It's not my friend. It's not me by myself. I can think and find out, you know, what's the best thing to do in life, you know, what's the best religion. Because religion, the definition of religion is a way of life, a complete way of life. And who can give you the complete instruction or the guidance to live your life? The Creator. Now, how does the Creator communicate with you to tell you what is your purpose in life? It is through the revelations, through the scriptures. And when we learn about Islam, we learn that there are scriptures that have been revealed before, and even the Quran, that itself is a revelation from God, the last one, you know. So it's not a very new thing. It's been there from the beginning of time, you know. From the beginning of time, there always has been one way of life. There has always been one God who we need to worship, and only one way to worship Him. So why, one would ask this question, so why then so many, you know, religions in the world? That is because people made the divisions. The original religion was just one. The original message from God is to worship Him, to submit to Him. Islam is not a new religion. It's been there from the beginning of time, and it will be there till the end of time. So that's how my process of thinking was, you know. That's how my thinking process went. And then alhamdulillah, I came to Islam. In my friend's house one day, I met another person who was also a revert. He was a Hindu before, and then he, you know, reverted. You know, we say revert, we don't say convert, because I haven't changed my religion from one religion to other. I have returned back to the correct religion, the true religion that I was born in. The Prophet, peace be upon him, he says in one hadith that every child is born upon the fitrah. The fitrah is the natural way of life, the Islamic way of life. That is the fitrah. That is the pure way, you know, our natural inclination towards belief in one God. Islam has changed my life upside down. So If I think about it now, I feel very blessed. I feel very happy. I feel that, you know, I've been chosen by the Almighty to be here today, because I was just like any other person living in the world, you know, not very concerned about religion, not worried about God, not worried about rules, you know. They say, some people, they say, rules are meant to be broken. That's a very bad statement there, you know. Come on. So, that's the life I was living, you know. Don't follow rules, don't do anything. Just live the way you like, you know. Live the way your heart wishes. Just live, just enjoy life. You only live once. But then, when Islam came, changed my life. It made me serious about life. It made me think at every step, every action that I do, I think before I do that. You know, I just don't do it randomly. Everything that I do, I think about it. Why I'm doing this? This is a very big question that you should ask, you know, at all the time, every moment in your life. You should ask, why? Why am I doing this? Why am I doing that? Why am I praying? Why am I fasting? Everything has a reason. And this is how, you know, Islam changed my life. My friend, he took me to his house and he showed me Dr. Zakir Naik's lecture, Concept of God in Major Religions. And you know, I got a very good idea from that. You know, I just really started thinking, and you know, some of the questions which I had myself, you know, many people over there, they asked, you know, to him. And then it was very satisfying answers that he gave. And that's what made me thinking, and that's what made me realize that this is the right way to life. This is the correct way of life. So that's how, you know, I came to, you know about Islam. That's how I became Muslim. My family, in the beginning, they took time to realize that, you know, this has happened. You know, it took time for them to believe that, yeah, this is actually happening. But when they realized it, they came out and they, you know, showed me that they are completely against it. And which is very normal, because they themselves haven't thought about life, you know, this way. They're just following what their parents have taught them, and then their parents have taught them, you know. Just so for those who maybe, you know, want to learn about this, you know, they want to open their minds, you know, this is what you need to do. Actually, you need to open up your thinking, you need to open up your mind, because from the day we were born and you've been living in that environment, you've just been there in that, you know. You don't think outside of that. You know, someone tells you something, you just filter it out. No, don't do that. You need to go out, you need to open up your mind, you need to start asking questions. Be honest with yourself. Know that, you know, things are out there for you to, it's waiting for you to just explore.
ذكر رحمة ربك عبده زكريا إذ نادى ربه نداء خفيا قال رب إني وهن العظم مني واشتعل الرأس شيبا